Good morning, good morning. It's here at the Queen's Hour of 3 to 57. And oh my gosh. I know, I hit the divulgence and back into my peerage, the peerage of my aristocracy, so my lineage there, back to Guillaume's, back to the prisons of Africa. Yay, this is my ownership, great. Wonderful, hello. Yeah, I guess so. We come from the backbone heart of the mean aggressions and probably deep into the slave trades also. Well, yeah, well, so much for that, huh? So much for that. It's over, thank God. It's over this. So, I'm in this like, okay, right. I try to get remove myself from genealogy, however, and the discussions of which king and queen I facet from, and yes, Spain is included also. I'll stop all of this, and I'll go. We all want to run and say, King of Spain. My brother is the King of France, because yes, I guess so. Technically, they are. Yeah, you know, you get on their high horses. They are there, and so congratulations to them for that. I'm not really wanting that regimentation of that capitulation of Pope Mobile. It's not really where I want to go. Back down into the lords there. That's not really necessary. My gosh, what a Catholic. Group that one particular way went. There's not much I can do about all of its mediocrities and idiosyncrasies of religion, and my gosh, slank it down like you can't believe to the you're all, you know, you just go away from God for a moment and you deserve to be whipped. No, I don't, sorry about that, but from before, sorry about that. Really bad, huh? Really bad upbringing there in my bloodline. So, well, anyway, what I am really discussing here is the France. Is I'm talking about the ease that has been going on. The ease that has been going on with the direction of, oh my goodness, how easy the EU, easy EU has made it for everyone. That, and so we're all hating the EU as persons indigenous are hating the EU for what it has done, because it has allowed globalization of persons, anyone who wants, any business who wants to move in and just take, you know, and level the ground out and become become terrible farms, gross. And they would not have done this normally. This would not have happened normally. I don't believe so. I think it can happen, and in a larger circumstance, like you see the America. You see in America, they have destroyed the inner sides of America completely with the agricultural farm, and this was allowed because America is so big and disgustingly large in the center that it was not a big deal. Nobody even noticed. Nobody from the coasts where the populations are noticed. But here we notice, here we are noticing. It is not something you can hide. So in this also, we have the ease of this massive population on this British Isle. The British Isle has a massive population. And so in this giddy up, get going, everybody, another baby, and they even pay for them to have the children. In this new feed that they've been giving again and again and again, there is a moment that is like, well, what is their momentum here? It is a population war. This is their momentum. They are having a population war. Now, more of us. This is their mantra. And they are using this. They have used this all over the world. They have used this in India. They have used this all over the world. We tried to do this into Hong Kong. They have gone immediately. We can live right there. We know all over Africa. has happened with them, and they're not getting out of it. They are the globalists, and they have been the globalists, and they have gone in and tried colonialism everywhere, and so it is not stopping. And here I am now on the France, and they have done this. They have brought themselves here to the French soil. They have brought themselves here to the French soil, just like in previous years past, they have brought themselves to the Irish soil. Just in uppetencies. Oh, we can purchase it, it's cheaper now, we can purchase it. Just in uppetencies. That is exactly what they did to Ireland. They moved in slowly and they purchased it. They did not move in with an army immediately, they moved in with their money and purchased. They bought the lands, and then what? They created serfs, the serfdoms. And so this is where I live now. I live surrounded by the poverty-stricken serfs of the British. I live surrounded by poverty-stricken serfs of the British. Now, in this disgust, they are angry at me also. They hate me, I'm imagining so. Because I am Auslander Raus. They cannot stand me. They cannot stand that I'm here also in this poverty-stricken situation. Because it is a direction. It is a direction for them to be direct owners allowed, to have the capacity to just go meander here and fickle over there and fickle over there. And it's not a soil they love, it's not a soil they want, it is not theirs. It's only merely for a queen or a king's expansionism. That is the thought in their head. They will do it for the king, they will do it for the queen. This is their thought in their head. But it's all truth and reality, they are doing it for enterprise. They are doing it for business enterprise. They're not doing it for the queen, they're not doing it for the king. However, as a tactic, they have used the king and the queen as the expansionism. Hey, we can do it. We are allowed because we have to do it for them. You know what I mean? So this is what we have to do. We have to stop the expansionism. Stop the expansionism of such, you know, whatever. You know, in any moment, you know, they are. They were fighters. They are fighters and idiots. Whatever they want, you know, they will fight for their country. They're not going to be fighting for France. They'll be fighting for their particular land of origin. So I'm going with the 10%. I'm going with the 10% rule. The 10% meaning, you have to be of descent, origin from the France soil, from France. If you are going to be purchasing any property, whether it is a house in a hamlet on a farm, whether it is the entire farm on surround, I do not want Auslanders who have never ever. Had ancestors here, living here, breathing here, birthing here, dying here. I do not want them here ever purchasing land, property, that is a farm occupancy. Because once it has become a farm occupancy, it is an enterprise. Meaning it is an enterprise war. They are skillets possible to be an enterprise war. Once it is an enterprise sort of war, there is an instancy of waging, engaging financial markets and pitting them against each other, pitting the French into a lower less than over the British, and that's what's going on right now. We are facing an Irish occupancy. Similar that has happened, I believe it was in the 1800s, quite heavy. So with the British and the Irish. So the same thing is going on right now here in France, and this is our urgency. This is our urgency to stop it. So 10%, that's it. And that's easy. It's easy for some of you. You may have 10%. You know, you may have a grandmother or a great-grandmother or great-grandfather out there that is direct French. And so there, then there's your 10% easily. I believe 25 begins if you have the 100% right away, one of your grandmothers. So what can I say about all of you, aside from we have to lay these rules down, because what has gone on in Hungary, what has gone on when you have these massive takeovers of an enterprise, that just, there's no way a single business in Hungary would have done that to their lands. I do not believe so. I do not believe they would have taken and toppled it to that degree, to that methodology. I believe that was an outsider source that just went and just platformed the entire area into a savannic state of distress. No, this has to be an expedient stop, immediate. Yeah, these persons are not even living, you know, they're not even really habitating here. They're just like visitors, you know. It's just like, it's a gross thing. Gross thing that's gone on and been allowed to go on. So anyway, we stay with the 10%, and then it's still expressing cosmopolitan, because you can still be the cosmopolitan. You can still have your metros of life going on in a big city that can still be a continuant, and it will be still a continuant. There will be purchases there allowed. I'm talking about the farms. I'm talking about the farmland. Once it is a farm, you are dealing with the absolute truth, and these are the locals. These are the persons who have lived here, died here for centuries. We do not need this disruption from Auslanders. We do not need this disruption from strangers who have no participation in ownership, normal, of heritage, merely a fashion of enterprise takeover. We have to stop the enterprise takeover people. So that's the way it goes. And yes, it will mean your farms will lower in value, and, well, congratulations. The British will only then be able to buy farms in Britain. The French will only be able to buy the farms in France. So it will all even out there in the price. Same goes for Spain. I don't want Spain being demonstrated upon either and taken over easily or quickly. People try. They're in their immobilian offices trying, and the English spoken everywhere is getting a little boring on everyone, isn't it? English spoken everywhere. That any immobilian, any land takeover, sure, English spoken anywhere, we just gonna let them have it all. Is that the way it is? Is that the way it's been going? Yes, that's the way it's been going. So we have to stop them and realize they are a war event.